So now I want to start talking about a very important problem in matrix algebra. It's called the eigenvalue problem. It shows up in physics. I think it was introduced by studying the rotation of solid objects. It flowered in quantum mechanics, where the eigenvalues were the energy levels of the atoms. And it's widely used in mechanical engineering, civil engineering, when you study the vibrations of things like bridges or mechanical machines. So what is the eigenvalue problem? Well, if we have an n by n matrix A, so A is n by n, the eigenvalue problem states that A times x equals lambda times x, okay? X is a column vector and lambda is a scalar. So it means you multiply a column vector by A, you get back the column vector, and you just multiply it by a number, lambda. This lambda is what we call the eigenvalue. And this x is what we call the eigenvector. Okay? So for each eigenvalue, you have an associated eigenvector. So the eigenvalue problem is that given a n by n matrix A, you want to find its eigenvalues and its eigenvectors. So those are the scalars and the vectors that can satisfy this equation. In this video, we're going to try and show you how to solve this problem, and I will find the eigenvalues at least for a 2x2 matrix. So how do you tackle this problem? A is n by n matrix. So the way to do this is to introduce an n by n matrix on the right-hand side of this equation also. It's not that hard to do. All we need to do is introduce the identity matrix. So Ax equals lambda, and then we sneak in an n by n identity matrix onto the right-hand side. So now we have an n by n matrix times a column vector x equals an n by n matrix. Lambda I is just a matrix with lambda going down the diagonals times another column vector. So we can regroup the terms here, and we can write Ax minus lambda I. Minus lambda I x equals 0. That's fine. And then we can factor out the x. So then we can finally write A minus lambda I times x equals 0. So now we have an n by n matrix times an n by 1 column vector equals 0. Okay? We just learned about determinants. We know that if the determinant of A minus lambda I was not 0, then A minus lambda I would have an inverse matrix. And then we can multiply on the left by the inverse, and then we would get x equals 0. X equals 0 is always a solution of Ax equals lambda x, and that's called the trivial solution, because it doesn't really tell us what we want to know. What we want to know are the values of lambda and the vectors x that satisfy this equation, where the vectors x are not just the zero vectors. They're something other than zero. So in order for this to have a solution other than x equals zero, the determinant of this matrix has to be zero. Okay? This cannot be an invertible matrix. So the determinant of A minus lambda I has to be 0. That's the equation for the eigenvalue lambda. That's called the characteristic equation. Characteristic equation of the matrix A. Okay, that's the fundamental equation in the eigenvalue problem. What is the characteristic equation? What type of equation is it? We know the determinant of an n by n matrix You can calculate that, right? You need to take an element from the first row and multiply by an element in the second row and an element in the third row. And then you have all these terms, right? But you always have, in each row, you have a lambda, right? So you, the first row has, along the diagonal, is A11 minus lambda. The second row at the diagonal is A22 minus lambda. So each row has a lambda in it. So when you construct, you do the expansion to get the determinant of A minus lambda I, you end up with a polynomial equation in lambda. So in fact, this is a nth order, because A is n by n. This is an nth order polynomial equation in lambda. Okay? What is a polynomial equation, right? So C1 lambda to the nth plus C2 lambda to the nth minus 1 plus Cn equal to 0. That's a polynomial equation, okay? These polynomial equations have roots. There are, in fact, n roots, if you include the concept that roots can be repeated. The roots can be real, the roots can be complex. So we can, in the rest of this lecture, I can show you an example. We can consider a general 2x2 matrix and try to compute the eigenvalues of that matrix. So let's start with a general 2x2 matrix, A, B, C, D. And we try to compute the determinant of A minus lambda I equal to 0. So the characteristic equation of a general 2x2 matrix. So you see how the eigenvalues come out in the simple case of 2x2. So determinant of A minus lambda I equals 0. That one looks like A minus lambda, B, C, D minus lambda. So the determinant of this 2x2 matrix. We know how to do the determinant of 2x2 matrices. This is A minus lambda times D minus lambda, right? The diagonal minus B, C. We can expand this quadratic. So minus lambda times minus lambda is lambda squared. Minus A lambda minus D lambda is minus A plus D lambda. And then AD minus BC is plus AD minus BC. And that's supposed to be 0. That's the characteristic equation. Okay, this is in general the characteristic equation for a 2x2 matrix. Just out of for your information, this A plus D term is the sum of the diagonal elements of the matrix A. That has a name, that's called the trace of A. And the AD minus BC term is the determinant of the matrix A. So this is lambda squared minus trace of lambda plus determinant equals 0. That's a general form for a 2x2 matrix. But it doesn't really matter. You can just remember how to calculate. Okay, so for the eigenvalue problem for a 2x2 matrix, the eigenvalues are a solution of this quadratic equation. And then there are three possibilities. So the quadratic equation, right, ax squared plus bx plus c equals 0, has the quadratic formula as the roots, negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. Everybody learns that in secondary school, in high school. But the for a quadratic equation, that b squared minus 4ac could be positive, it could be negative, or it could be 0. So you have three possibilities for a quadratic equation. You can have two real values of lambda, okay? So two real eigenvalues. Or you can have b squared minus 4ac negative, and then you take the square root of a negative number. So you can have complex eigenvalues. So complex lambdas. And then the third case would be b squared minus 4ac equals 0. So then you only have one real lambda. So that one has a word. We say that the eigenvalues are degenerate. OK? So there are three possibilities. I think to see what the eigenvectors look like, we should work some more concrete examples. And I want to show you some matrix that may have complex eigenvalues or may just have degenerate eigenvalues. So we'll be doing that in the next videos. So to summarize, we're doing considering the eigenvalue problem, a very important problem in science and engineering. We consider an n by n matrix, and we try to solve the equation Ax equals lambda x for the eigenvalue lambda and the eigenvector x. That leads us to the characteristic equation of the matrix, determinant of A minus lambda I equals 0. That's an nth order polynomial equation for lambda. And then I work the case when A is a 2 by 2 matrix. I'm Jeff Chasnov. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.